Welcome back. For today's video, going to be taking a look at three polls that have come out after the third Democratic debate. Two of them are taking a look at the national landscape, and then one of them is state-specific, looking at California. In that California poll is how we're going to be wrapping things up. And the state of California this time around is much more important because it's very early on in the process, and being the most populous state, it has the most pledged delegates up for grabs. So if one or two of these candidates can do much better than the rest of the pack in that state and get a large share of those pledged delegates, it can be a huge boost and catalyst potentially for those candidates. And we got some really interesting numbers coming out from California. So that's how we'll wrap things up. But first, I want to take a look at the national numbers. So this week's morning consult, we see that Joe Biden's still in first place at 32%, followed by Bernie Sanders, who's in second place at 20%. Both Biden and Sanders are just down one percentage point each, respectively, from where they were in the morning consult numbers before going into that third Democratic debate. And the big gainer, I guess you can say big gainer, even though it's really not that much of a change in the numbers, would be Elizabeth Warren, where before the debate, she was at 16%. So gaining a couple of points there, up to 18 percentage points. And it continues to feel more and more like this is going to be a three-way race between Biden, Sanders, and Warren, as we see the rest of the candidates just continuing to hover in the mid to lower single digits. So in fourth place, we have Kamala Harris at 6 percentage points. Fifth place, Pete Buttigieg at 5 percentage points. And these two, amongst the rest of the pack, have been the most interesting throughout this process. Now, these are two younger candidates that are viewed as up and coming in the Democratic establishment, more so than how progressives would view them. But they each had their moment in the sun, but have not seen much in the way of catalyst since then. So for Pete Buttigieg, it was extremely early on in the process where he had his initial boost, and he's kind of been receding since then. And I think maybe part of it was the controversy that he had surrounding him and continues to surround him with his policing situation, where he is the mayor of South Bend and all that he had to deal with. That seems to be one of the catalysts that saw his numbers go down since that point in time. And then also Kamala Harris saw a big boost up in her numbers after the first debate, but since then, she hasn't had as strong performances in the second or third debate, and her numbers have precipitously gone down since that first boost that she got. And it seems more or less like the Kamala Harris support has been coalescing behind somebody like Elizabeth Warren, who has seen gradual improvements in her numbers over the past few months. But then behind the top five candidates, we have in sixth place Beto O'Rourke taking a little bit of a jump up here to 4 percentage points. In seventh place, both Cory Booker and Andrew Yang at 3 percentage points respectively. And then in ninth place, Amy Klobuchar at 2 percentage points. Now, taking a look at the early primary states, this would be Iowa, New Hampshire, Nevada, and South Carolina. Joe Biden and Bernie Sanders still in first and second place, and not big changes between their national numbers and their early primary state numbers, just slight increases here. So Biden at 34 percentage points, Bernie Sanders at 21 percentage points, but a big drop off from Elizabeth Warren in contrast to her national numbers, where the early stage she's only at 13 percentage points. And this is a possible headwind for the Warren campaign. A lot of the primary has to do with momentum building. You have to, by and large, do well in those early states to kind of build momentum behind your candidacy, and that can really be a positive catalyst going into states that come later on. Now, if Elizabeth Warren is underperforming her national numbers in these early states, that could potentially hurt her chances at going on and winning the nomination, but she could also potentially see her national numbers go down as people see other candidates like potentially a Biden and Sanders going on and picking up a lot of these pledged delegates, where people might view Warren as a weaker candidate, and maybe they change their support either over to Biden or Sanders as a result. That's definitely a headwind that her campaign could be facing, but there's still a long way to go before we get to those early states, and Warren will continue to put in the work to try to boost up her numbers in those early state results, and we'll see if she has success in doing so, because the success of her campaign really could come down to boosting up those numbers in those early states so that it can match what we're seeing from her on the national scale. And then we also see the rest of the candidates here, how they shape up. We have Buttigieg and Harris each at 5 percentage points with those early states. And then Tom Steyer, he's pumping a ton of money into advertisements in these early primary states. And you can see his numbers are having an effect based on that. Cory Booker, Tulsi Gabbard, and Beto O'Rourke each at 3 percentage points respectively with those early states. And you can see the trend lines over time, where Sanders has been really steady over the past few months. Biden saw a big dip after that first debate performance that was really weak, but he's been pretty steady since then. And then Elizabeth Warren, this purple line here, we can see the gradual improvement from her numbers over the past few months. Kamala Harris, that big boost after the first debate, but then we've seen quite a precipitous decline since that point in time. And then just to take a look at the second choice amongst the voters of these upper tier candidates, and it's actually pretty similar amongst all these top three candidates. So Biden, their second choice is pretty similar between Sanders and Warren at 28 and 26 percentage points respectively. And then the same with Sanders, the second choice is between Biden and Warren at 29 and 28 percentage points respectively. And then also with Elizabeth Warren, it's pretty split between Bernie Sanders and Joe Biden at 23 and 22 percentage points respectively, but also Kamala Harris getting a little bit more in this one compared to the other two candidates there at 16 percentage points. Now, a potential positive for Elizabeth Warren, if Harris and Buttigieg aren't doing well early on in the process and they drop out, she could really see a boost up in her numbers because the second choice amongst Harris supporters is Elizabeth Warren at 28 percentage points. And then the second choice amongst Buttigieg supporters is also Elizabeth Warren there at 25 percentage points. So that could possibly help her candidacy. So now moving on, and actually, I want to take another look, diving into the numbers a little bit more from this week's morning consult. And they asked an interesting question. So they said, if the Democratic presidential primary or caucus in your state were being held today, who would you absolutely not vote for? And this is potentially a positive for Sanders and Warren, who are trying to chase down Joe Biden because he has the most distaste amongst Democratic primary voters, where 20% of the voters said that they would not vote for Joe Biden, absolutely not vote for him. And 26% of those people are men, 15% women. And you compare that to the other candidates where that number is only 5% for Elizabeth Warren and 12 percentage points for Bernie Sanders. So the fact that there's the most distaste potentially there for Joe Biden and people that won't vote for him, maybe that's a scenario where he can be a candidate that's exploited somehow in terms of the negatives that he has going for him. Maybe that can be a catalyst to candidates like a Warren and Sanders who don't have quite as much distaste based on what the numbers are telling us for their candidacy as opposed to what we're seeing from Joe Biden. Now going on and taking a look at the national numbers from Rasmussen, and not much in the way of changes here. Joe Biden still in first place at 29% of support, followed by Bernie Sanders in second place at 14%, Elizabeth Warren at 12 percentage points, Kamala Harris at 6, Pete Buttigieg at 4, Beto O'Rourke at 3, Cory Booker at 3, Julian Castro at 2 percentage points. And we're actually seeing pretty similar numbers in terms of that national picture from Rasmussen as what we were seeing over from the morning consult. Now I want to wrap things up, but taking a look at a poll that just came out a couple of hours ago, and this is from Emerson, taking a look at the state of California. And we can see in first place, basically a tie here at 26 percentage points apiece between Biden and Sanders. In third place, we have Elizabeth Warren at 20 percentage points, and quite a gap between these top three candidates and what we're seeing from the rest of the field. But a very strong showing from Andrew Yang at 7% support. It doesn't surprise me to see Yang doing well out in a state like California, where just in terms of the overall picture, he's been doing really well in terms of his online engagement, especially amongst young voters in a state like California. It can have a positive impact for his candidacy as opposed to maybe other states that aren't quite as in tune to the online scene, especially with social media, as you might see out in California. And then just a disastrous poll. The senator from the state of California is Kamala Harris, and she's polling even behind Andrew Yang in this one at 6% of support, followed by O'Rourke at 5%, Buttigieg at 4%, Gabbard at 2 percentage points, and then all the other candidates at 1 percentage point or less. And it's interesting taking a look at where these candidates do well. So driving the support for Sanders is continuing to be voters under the age of 50. He has 34% of support, followed by Warren at 18, and then Biden at 16, and Andrew Yang at 11% amongst those voters under the age of 50. And then this also is a trend that we generally see where Bernie Sanders does well amongst Hispanic voters. So Hispanic voters in California, he's leading that group with 36% support, followed by Biden at 23%, and then Warren at 19 percentage points. Now, the older age demographic, this is where Biden, it's his bread and butter, and it's a big positive for his campaign because in general, especially in primaries, you see older voters participating at a much higher rate than younger voters, and Biden doing well with the over 50-year-old age demographic with 40% support, followed by Warren at 23. And Bernie Sanders not doing as well there at just 13% support. Now, white voters, this is where Elizabeth Warren tends to do her best amongst this demographic. And she leads white voters with 29%, followed by Sanders at 20%, and then Biden at 18%. And it's a very interesting trichotomy here where we have the top three candidates. Biden tends to do the best amongst African Americans. Sanders tends to do the best amongst Hispanics. And then Warren tends to do her best amongst white voters. For whatever reason, that is how things have been playing out among these candidates. So that's pretty much going to wrap up what I wanted to touch on here, looking at the state of California and how things are looking. And again, California is so important this time around, given the fact that it's been moved up very early on in the process. You have to reach that 15 percentage point threshold to be part of the candidates that divvy up those pledged delegates. So in this instance, you would get Biden, Sanders, and Warren divvying up that massive amount of pledged delegates from the state of California. And that would really propel their chances at going on and potentially winning the nomination, especially in contrast to the rest of the field kind of separating themselves from the rest of the pack. So that's going to wrap this video up, guys. I appreciate you stopping on in. If you want to take a look at all this data for yourself, I'll have links posted down in the description. So consider subscribing to the YouTube channel, and hope to see you guys back here for my next video.